And it's in, is it? No, what a save by Roberto from Tom Davis, denying the Everton midfielder Walcott. Walcott into the penalty area. Bernard declines the opportunity to shoot, twists and turns, and scores! How about that from Bernard? What brilliance! It looked as though he passed up the opportunity. Instead, he produces a moment of pure magic. Luca Dean takes. Away by Ogbonna, and it's fine as Walcott. Oh, so unlucky that. What a hit it was. What a strike from Theo Walcott. Deserved a goal, this. Sidibe. Sidibe for Iwobi to finish things. Good save, Roberto, but Iwobi should have scored for Everton. He knows that. The Evertonians know it. Lanzini takes. It's headed down. And brilliantly saved by Jordan Pickford. What a stop that was. Well, that is as good as a goal at the other end. To give Everton the points, that is. He's working hard to win it back, and so is Richarlison. Sigurdsson, he's got it on his right foot, and that finishes it brilliantly. It's been a long time in coming, that second goal, but it does finally arrive in stoppage time to huge cheers inside Goodison Park. Oh, what a fine finish it was. Gylfi Sigurdsson on as a late substitute. Ensures Everton get the 3 points.
Come on, guys, come on!
The beginning, guys, huh?
Yeah. Where are you guys?
Yes,
Lucas.
It's good?
Yeah.
Come on,
thank you.
Thank you.
it's on. And then take a picture. Press that button there. That's it. Bit down a bit.
This is our little mini stadium announcer for today.
This is.
Take your magic off.
Nice to meet you, okay?
Yeah. Do you want a picture with him?
There's
Monk. Oh, look at that. He's very. He's feeling a bit nervous.
Today we must celebrate the BBC's children in need, and we have a mini stadium announcer to announce the team's for you. Please welcome young Calvin to Goodison Park.
Again.
Do you have, well, the way VAR is being implemented, I'm thinking in particular of the incident where Yerry Mina scores, but the referee's whistle had already gone before the ball even hit the back of the net, so that couldn't even be reviewed. But there were a number of other decisions across the Premier League last week as well.
I can talk about first hour game and that, not just that decision, but some of the others, about that decision in our corner. I think I didn't understand. I think no one in the stadium understood as well. Even the people who was watching on TV, for sure they didn't understand, because we didn't see nothing. Nothing happened there to even for the referee to blow the whistle, like you said. It's really difficult to understand why one moment, normal moment, we can score a goal and you scored, and even the referee didn't give time for us to finish that moment. A little bit strange, that situation, because after they had one chance with the only chance they had during the game, more or less the same thing in our box, clear free kick and win, and the referee leave the game goes until the end, and Jordan had that moment and saved that chance they had. Difficult to understand, but okay, it's the decision the referee, and we have to accept, even if it was really difficult to understand. About VAR and about the situation, of course, in that moment, if the referee leaves the game go until the end, and after can see what everyone saw in the stadium was not foul at all. The Yerry Mina, I think, was the best decision, to be honest with you. And in my opinion, is the decision they are taking more. I think because they are leaving the game goes, and after they have to take decision, is easy to understand. Even the assistants, they are doing that in some doubts in the offside position. They are leaving the moment to go until the end, and after, and let's see if he's or not offside. I think is the best way to do that, and to be honest and to be fair with them, big part of them, they are doing that. About the VAR and about the decision, I know last weekend was again a weekend when everyone talked many times about the decisions VAR or the support VAR can give or not to the referees. My opinion, they should keep giving the best support for the ref. If you ask me if they can stop and the referee to go to see, I think it is not necessary, to be honest. I think if the people and the assistants are there, the VAR are there to see the situation, they have the competence to see, because it's so clear. You are talking about clear mistakes, and it's easy to understand if it's a mistake or not. My opinion, you don't need to stop the game for the referee to go to see the screen there, because we'll stop more times the game, the stop will be bigger. I think the fans will hate that situation for sure, and I think you don't need, because the people is there supporting the referee, they have all the competences to see what is a clear mistake or not.
Surprised at that, only because it seems there's a reluctance from the VAR officials to re-referee the game, and maybe if the official himself was prepared to go to that monitor a little bit more, then we wouldn't have so many controversies as we've had over the past few weeks.
Yeah, but after you have to look in a different way as well. What we talk about Premier League, the pace, the intensity, the game, like the game was, what is the big passion for everyone, and why Premier League is so special, because we like to see the intensity. If the referee has to be to go in the screen to stop the game, I think we'll stop more time the game. I think will not be good. And for me, we have to give the responsibility for the VAR, the people is supporting the referee, to see and to take the right decision, because it's so clear. We are talking about clear mistakes, and clear mistakes they are. Last weekend, you can talk about some of them again, and it was so clear that the decisions, I think, is the best way to the referee don't go, because I have some experience when I saw the referee every time went there to see in the screen, stop the game many times. I think it's not a good solution, to be honest.
Looking ahead to the weekend, good or bad news at the moment for Yerry Mina?
Not so good at the moment, not so good news. Of course, we have more than two days until the game, more one day tomorrow to prepare the game. Let's see how it will be tomorrow and in the match day as well. It's not a serious injured, but it's something until now he didn't put Yerry Mina ready to work with the team in the full session.
Does that mean then that someone like Mason Holgate is ready and prepared to step in?
Yeah. Yeah, ready, he's prepared, he's ready, show to me every single day he's working hard to achieve and to get his chance. He already did in two Carabao Cup game matches. He did well, he performed well. The game against Sheffield United, he did a very good game as well. And I'm 100% sure if he'll have the chance, he will be ready to perform in his level, because we believe on him.
What about Fabian Delph? Schneider, are they both available and fully fit?
No, they work until now, full session with his teammates as well, and they are both ready.
So you've got a few decisions facing this weekend. You keep Iwobi in the number 10 role. Obviously, Gilfie responded with a goal last week. You keep Richarlison up front. Go with Gomez and Davis again in midfield. And does Sidibe keep Coleman out again?
Good headache is what I want. And when this happens, when we achieve good results, when players get their chance and they perform well and they help the team, it's a very good thing for me as a coach. I like to have this type of headaches. That means the players aren't on the bench, they have the quality to play, and they are working hard to play. The players are playing means they did a good performance as well, like was the situation against West Ham. It's a very good headache for me, is what I like, and it's up to them to keep working. And after, of course, each match you can have your your plan to the match. Last match we decided in one way and the team performed really well. It was a very good performance, not just because we won the game, but the performance was really good, quality, mobility, pace and intensity in our game. Was a good week again, a good competition between them. It's up to me to decide Saturday what will be the best 11, but I agree with you. Good headaches to decide the 11 for the next match. I have one plan. We are working on that plan, but with one more session to do tomorrow, more 48 hours to play the game. Of course, I didn't decide everything, but I have a plan, and the things are clear in my mind what we should do against a tough opponent in the tough match.
Is there as much pressure to build on last week's results as there was just to get that next?
I understand your question and why you are asking me, because we performed so well. We showed that quality, that proud in ourselves as well to play in the level we played, to give that answer we did. Of course, we have to build from that. We have to build from that. We have to believe it was a turning point for us. That means we'll not win all the matches until the end of the season, of course, but we have to playing that way always to win that the match, as always, with that we're proud in ourselves, with that pace, that desire to win the game, that desire to play freedom like we did, even if the pressure was there. We played so freedom with that confidence. Looks in some moments the games we were winning the last five games, instead we are not with a good result. And of course, you can talk again. Okay, it's a must-win game for us again. Let's go and let's play. Respect Brighton. Will be a tough one. Quality team. Very good work from Potter as well as a manager there. But we have to go in the same way. And let's see the result in the end.
Certainly, looking at Brighton, it appears that they play better than their points total would suggest so far this season.
Yeah, I agree. Quality in their football. Clear. The model, what they try to build as well, completely different than what they did the last two seasons as well. The way they are trying to play, the way they are building their attacks as well. They are being brave as well. The way they are playing against not just home, away as well, with quality, creating chances, being a tough team for all the opponents as well, and will be a tough one. Of course, they need points, but we need as well. We need as well. We should go there to play with a win in our mind. Thinking is a must-win game for us again, because in Everton Football Club, all the games has to be a must-win game. But they are thinking the same. I'm 100% sure in the way they will play and the way they will approach the game, because in the last few games against us, some teams are changing a little bit the way they are playing. I don't believe they will change many, many things, because they approach all the games this season in one way, in being brave, playing to win the football matches as well, and I think will be a tough game for both teams, and let's hope we can perform better than them and being more solid than them and score the enough goals to win.
And at this stage, do you look at the table and see just how tight it is and how a couple of wins back to back can really shoot you up that table once again?
Yeah, we want to go for the position as higher as you can in the table. Of course, the hour before the last game, our last period was not so good, and in the end, put us in one position on the table. You don't at all. It's not what we want. It's not our goal. Of course, we reacted last game, and we should react again, and we should improve from what we did last one. Keep that quality, keep that desire, and because with a good results, we can go higher on the table. And of course, it's our goal. It's what we want after to challenge our goals until the end.
Just finally, then, is it really? Do you feel the away record getting the results away from home, a blip against Sheffield United can almost be forgiven, can't it?
Yeah. Being the most honest possible, not good enough what we are doing away. Not good enough at all. We have the quality to do more. We must do more away. And we have to look for this game. Thinking has to be our first win away. Has to be the game we should play to score goals, more goals away, because we are not scoring the enough goals away as well. And being solid as a team, because just with this desire, scoring goals and being solid, we can win away games in Premier League. Of course, last season we improved what was our away performance than the seasons before. But we should do better this season again and improve what we did last season. Until now, we didn't achieve the results we want. In some moments, we deserve as well away, because if you look for all the performances away, doesn't mean that our opponents, they were really better than us and they performed better than us. But the reality, they achieved the points and you didn't achieve. And we must improve, clear our away form, because the work we are doing home, all the points you are getting home, the our home form, we have to support that with good away games as well and good performance and good results away.
Marco, what difference have you noticed around the club, around the training ground this week after that result against West Ham?
Okay, the mood is completely different, like you expect, or like is normal in the situations when you come from a tough man. We before the West Ham match, we came from a tough man for us. Before the first international break, we were 6 on the table. After the 4 games, we were not really good on the table as well. And of course, the mood was not the best, like is normal in one big club like Everton Football Club. We were not achieving the good results. The mood was not good, but we showed on the pitch, and the most important thing, our quality, our proud in some moments as well. Our desire to change and to change the results, to change the performance as well, with looking for that game as a must win, but looking for the game as well as a happiness moment for us, because we should play in this way. The crowd was really, really good, support our players, and of course after that, after the good result, we know we just get 3 points, nothing more. Many things to keep improving, many things to achieve, just 3 points, but the way you play it, like we were together, like I asked our fans as well, of course the mood this week was different. Working hard like always, keeping improving, keeping working to go and to brighten and to keep achieving good results, because of what we need this moment.
Do you feel different after the result as well?
Myself? Okay, I'm feeling more happy, like it's normal when you prepare one football match, and Saturday after the match you feel your players did what we planned. Our players perform really well, and look for our collective performance, and you see general collective performance was really good, not just because some of individual performance was good, but we as a team, we did really well. Our intense, the pace, the reaction in both moments when you lose or win the ball, everything what I like to see in my team. Okay, like is normal, I'm happy in that. And finished the game, I'm proud of my players and our fans as well, because they, in a tough moment for us, they support our players. But nothing changed more after that moment. I gave the congratulations to them and I start thinking in the next one, because you know, coaches like that, managers like that, you never switch off. You start always switch on and prepare the next one and start to thinking what will be the best plan to keep in this way. Okay, thank you, nice to see you.